So today we're going to talk about different struggles that we encounter every day and how we can possibly deal with them. So the first one is, you weren't able to reach your goals. Us millennials are believed to be the most active, competitive, and compulsive among the other generations. Gusto natin lahat ng mga isaset nating goals, nakukuha natin. And if we come to think about it, hindi naman siya negative eh. Kasi gusto lang natin na ma-improve kung ano yung meron at kung ano tayo ngayon. Nagiging mali lang naman siya kapag masyado tayo nag-focus doon sa goal na yun at nakakalimutan natin kung ano na yung mga na-achieve natin.
Lagi nating alalahanin na hindi naman lahat ng isaset nating goal ay makukuha natin. And in case na hindi man natin ito nakuha, it does not mean you are a failure. We could try a different approach to achieve that dream. Kasi kapag paulit-ulit yung approach natin, nagiging paulit-ulit yung result.
If we are going to change our approach towards that goal, it will also lead us to a different result. Someone criticized you.
Let us put on our minds na the height of your success is equivalent to the number of your critics. So kung mas marami yung mga critics mo, ibig sabihin, mas nagiging successful ka.
Say in the showbiz industry,
a person will get a lot of basher kapag sumisikat siya.
So if criticisms are bothering you, let us remember that not all criticisms are bad. We have what we call constructive criticisms. These are criticisms that we use to improve ourselves. When you are having financial troubles,
actually, there is goodness kapag medyo nagigipit ka sa pera.
Why? Because we learn how to prioritize. We learn to separate our wants and our needs.
Maybe you might want to delete that online shopping application on your phone. Because I have said before that millennials are compulsive. Kapag nakakita yan ng sale, 50% off, with or without money, they're going to order.
And another is that we should always live within our means.
Huwag na tayong mag-Starbucks kung di naman kaya. Huwag na tayong bumili ng gadgets kung di naman kaya.
Our relationship has ended.
According to studies, there is less than 1% of the world's total population who have met the one na hindi sila nakaranas ng heartbreaks, breakup, at hindi sila bound for divorce. Now, if you are not part of that pinagpalang less than 1% ng population, ibig sabihin, you're just going to try and try and try again until you find your true love.
Heartaches are a part of loving.
Now, how can we get over a heartache or a heartbreak? First is that you have to find yourself. You just have to discover who you are.
Face it. Your flaws, your weaknesses, your struggles, and everything that comes in between.
And during a heartbreak, that is also the best time to go on adventures.
It is now up to you on how you move forward from that. It's either you can enter into another relationship, or maybe you just need to improve yourself first, discover more about yourself, and meet more people.
Explore.
You can't feel contentment. As I have mentioned earlier, that millennials are very competitive. We are very good at comparing ourselves to others. During this pandemic, together with my cousins, we conducted a small relief operation for those people who are in need. And every time na nakikita ko na nagliliwanag yung mukha ng mga tao kapag inaabutan ko sila ng bigas, noodles, itlog, it just comes to show that how easily these people find happiness. And come to think of it, they have less than what I have. When I reached home, it suddenly came to me that there are really people who wants what I have. Like, how much I wanted what others have. So life is an endless wants. So as long as we are living, we are always wanting something. And the only way that that can stop is when you find your contentment.
One way on how we can possibly deal with discontentment is that when we stop focusing on ourselves. Kasi kapag nakafocus tayo sa sarili natin, ang nakikita natin, yung gusto natin, yung kailangan natin. Kung titingnan natin yung nasa paligid natin, nakikita natin kung paano tayo pwedeng tumulong sa iba.
Let us remember that these struggles were given to us because we can handle them. And when that time comes, people will look up to you and say that you did it. And then you will serve as their motivation in their own struggles.
So no matter how down you are, no matter how hard life gets, always remember that our struggles has their purpose.